Yes.
Today, on the fourth day of 9 days, we are really entering into the actions. Till today, we discussed about the reasons behind the French Revolution. On 14th July 1789, the people of Paris entered into the city with their weapons, spade, pickaxe, and all other weapons that were available with them, because most of them were peasants. They entered into the city of Paris and they destroyed the Bastille prison. You can see, why did they attack Bastille prison? Because the news was spread, king is going to ask the members of the third estate. It was a rumor. So ask for the rumor, if it happens, the members will be imprisoned in the Bastille prison. So the people decided to attack the Bastille prison and destroy it. So that is the beginning of the direct action of French Revolution. And that day, that is the 14th July, is declared as the National Day of France. So the revolution outright started on that. Now, the meeting of the Estate General. Yesterday I have told you there were 1,200 members. 300 from the first estate, 300 from the second estate, and 600 from the third estate. So all these members met together. But the king has decided that each estate will have one vote each. So majority decision. So when voting is taking place, first estate will have one vote, second estate one vote, and third estate one. So naturally, first and second will support the king, and whatever the king tells will be passed by the assembly, because two votes king gets and one vote will be opposite. So that was the decision of the king. First, third estate members were not happy with that decision. They disagreed with the proposal of the king. So when they disagreed with the proposal of the king, they cannot sit in the assembly. They came out. So they boycotted the assembly. Modern day, we can say the opposition members boycott the parliament. The parliament sessions are on. They say, we don't agree with the ideas or thinkings of the government, so we are boycotting the parliament. The same way, the third estate members boycotted the parliament and they came out of the estate general hall and they took an oath that they will not permit the king to collect more taxes. Whatever he is collecting, let him no more taxes, no permission for collecting the taxes. We will not accept any of the demands of the king. We will stand together. That oath was taken in the tennis court. It is known as famous tennis court oath. So that has happened. And that oath has happened on 20th June 1789. So the news reached the king. Naturally, king will be unhappy, I think, because he is ruling. He is absolute monarch. So he was unhappy and angry with the actions of the third estate members. So his reactions. Now, these third estate members till now were leaderless, because it was not a planned action. It was not an organized action. The people were not being them today on this morning, this time, we will start the revolution, nothing of that sort. So there was no proper elected leader or accepted leader. Now comes two members from the other estates as the leader who guided the members of the third estate. This was a doubt for the king.
That is why king did not agree for majority decision. King knew that some of the members of the first estate and second estate may support the third estate if individual voting is given. Then the desire of the third estate will be accepted. King will have no choice. That is why the king has told no individual voting. So these two members, there is a Abysius, a priest, he is himself is a priest, who has dedicated his services for the church as a priest, and Mirabeau, a nobleman. These two members came out of the first estate and second estate and joined with the third estate and helped them and guided them in the protest against the king. So that is what has happened. So it has become a leader organization. Till now, it was no plan, no leader, no proper thinking. So things are coming to a concrete shape now, slowly, slowly. Now, king had no choice. King had no choice. At last, he had to accept the demands of the third estate. And the third estate members made a constitution was written. You know what is a constitution? A rule book. What are the powers of the king? What are the powers of the ministers? What he can do, what he should not do, all those things were written on the constitution. So that constitution. And king accepted the constitution. King had no choice because the members were surrounded him and told him to sign. He has no choice. He signed. So he has to accept it. So the constitution was written and accepted. France becomes a constitutional monarchy in 1791. Constitutional monarchy. A country being ruled by a monarch but having a constitution. Example, presented also, you know, England. The country of England is ruled by or governed by an elected prime minister named Boris Johnson. He belongs to the Conservative Party. But there is a head of the country, that is Queen Elizabeth II. So that is a constitutional monarchy. And Queen has agreed to accept the demands put up by the Parliament and the Executive. That is under the Boris Johnson. Boris Johnson. Same way we have got in Asia, Japan. Akihito is there as the king. Mr. Abe is there as the prime minister. As another country, there is Morocco in Africa. These countries are having constitutional monarchy. Means the head of the country is a king or a queen. And government is run by elected members. So that is known as a constitutional monarchy. So king has agreed to be a constitutional monarch, means he has agreed to accept the rule as per the directions given by the National Assembly of France, the present name of the French Parliament. Then that National Assembly of France abolished the feudal system. Feudal system means, you know, everything is controlled by the feudal landlord. The village area will be under his control. He will allot some piece of the land for farmers to do the farming activity. Share should be given to the king or the feudal lord. So that system, that was abolished. If a farmer is having only control of some acres of the land, it will be his property. So feudal lords have no control on the areas of the villages. So the feudalism was abolished in France. Feudal privileges were abolished because they will be having anywhere they can go, free, no taxation, special facilities are there for them. So all those things, as in senior school system, you know, privileges for the seniors. They can take a shortcut to go to houses, the sacred. Like that, privileges were abolished by the French Assembly. Church properties were confiscated. Church,
He's having plenty of land and property because they belong to second estate, a first estate, and they got a lot of money, wealth. So everything was taken over by the French government. Then right to what? Universal adult suffrage. But that is what our dream is not.
In France, the voting right was given to a male member who is above 21 years and is able to pay a tax of 3 days' wage. Means, if a equal salary, means one day salary government accepted as 1,000 rupees per day. So he should be paying 3,000 rupees tax to the government. Then only he will get a right to vote. If you are not having that much money to pay or your income is below that, then you are not bound to pay to be a voter. You will not get the right to vote. And only male members, no females are permitted to vote. That is known as a universal adult franchise, that has. But it was not there at that time in France. Universal adult franchise came into existence in France after so many years. That's in 1920s. So the Declaration of Rights of Men and Citizen. The Parliament has decided what are the rights of men and citizens. Not women and citizens, only men are having the rights. Because they were in the forefront, only they were considered. Females were not considered at all for any of these activities. So that is what. So this is what the Declaration of Rights of Men and Citizens. Some of them are, I have not mentioned them, incorporated every, some rights. One of them are, men are born and remain free and equal in rights. So, an ordinary person is telling he is equal to the king. Yes, he is equal. Everybody is equal. Because of the chance, he might have become the ruler. Thus, all are born free. That is what it is. Rousseau has told, I told you in the first chapter, men are born free, but he is in chains everywhere. So he tells that Declaration of Rights of Men tells that all are born free and remain equal. All are equal. There's no difference. The rich, poor, educated, literate, talented, weak, healthy, unhealthy, everybody. All are equal, whether you are male or female, black or white or color, anything. You are equal. Political association are respected liberty, property, and security. Why political associations? Why political parties? Political associations are the organizations which is trying to capture power, to come to power using them. So freedom to form a political associations. And to do whatever is not in the others. I want to do, shake my hand, dance, and others, I can do, no problem. When you are in the class, you can do that. But other person who is sitting in the class has also got equal right. If he also extends the hand to dance and do, then clash will happen. So you do this kind of things in your area. You should not harm other person. So you should have the freedom to do whatever you want to do. No man can be accused, arrested, or detained except in cases determined by law, except that reason. You know, police will arrest you. It's a response of the police. But if a police arrests an innocent person, without any reason, the police person feels unhappy with somebody and he comes and arrests and puts him in jail or keeps him in a lockup. So that is the wrong. That should not happen. That is why he told her, no man can be accused, arrested or detained except in cases determined by law. If it's legally, if the person has done a wrong thing, he can be arrested. But there's a rule. If the person is arrested, he should be produced in front of a magistrate within 24 hours.
his or her family member should be informed about the arrest and should be given the reason for the arrest. So that is simply a police officer or anybody which cannot arrest anybody. There should be justification. That is why this liberty, they are asking for this kind. It was not there before that. If king feels unhappy with anybody, oh, catch him, bring him, cut his head, finish, not even question him. That was it. That is why they are telling, no, don't do such a kind of things from here onwards. No. Now, people are unhappy with the king. They are trying to abolish the monarchy. Kingship itself is abolished. Why that has happened? People have accepted a constitutional monarchy. Now the people tell, my dear fellow, thank you very much, out. Why? Because the king who was signed, Louis XVI who was signed, was unhappy with that signature and that decision. Somehow he wanted to crush the revolutionary movements. And the soldiers in France were not so much supporting him. So he is trying to contact his neighboring kingdom. That is a Prussia. You see, Prussia, not Russia, Prussia, present day Germany. Okay, at that time it was not Prussia. So he sent his messengers to Prussia, communicated, and asked the help of Prussia to destroy the revolutionary movements in France. And send a messenger to Austria. Austria is another country, a small country. The capital of Austria is Vienna. So, there, Austria. Both the countries agree. So, that has happened. People came to me about this action of the king. And the king has done secretly. So, people were very much angry. They charged him. Treason. Treason means a crime done against his own country. That's it. Treason. So, the king was charged with the treason. That has happened. Then, Parliament came to know about it. Parliament was unhappy with Prussia and Austria. So, when they were unhappy with Austria and Prussia, what is the option? If you are unhappy with somebody, you cannot whatever you like, but then a country can. The country declared war on Prussia and Austria. So the war went on. And that has led to the success story of Napoleon, the army general of that time. That we will see at the end of this unit. Then, elections were held. Male members, about 21 were permitted to vote. King and queen were imprisoned in August 1979. Monarchy was abolished by the people. So France becomes a republic. So a constitutional monarchy to a republic. What is a republic? Every day you are hearing. Every year you are celebrating Republic Day. What is a republic? Republic means the head of the country is elected. So, Japan is not a republic, Britain is not a republic, Morocco is not a republic, even Saudi Arabia, like this host country, are also not a republic, Bhutan is not a republic, because in all those countries, the heads of the country are not elected. It's a hereditary post. If the present day queen resigns or dies, does she not, does she will not, if dies, the power of England will go to her son Charles. 2 years ago, Japanese king Akihito resigned and Hirohito has become the king. So like that changes, the kingship also. So that is what the monarchy, abolition of monarchy, republic. So, republic is the government will be elected by the people and government functions as per the constitution. You see, this is a public day. In India, we have separate, we see those ones in Indian celebrations. So, that is why. Now, we see political associations and formations. Political associations, you know, this is done to gain power. And it is being done. And here one of the main figure is there, Robespierre. He has opened a political organization named Jacobin Club. This Jacobin Club became a prominent organization and it was led by Robespierre, which he took over the administration of complete France. And that led into the assassination or killing of the kings, capturing of the power, all those things. And these people were dressing like workers in the dock, because the in France or European countries, the nobles wear such kind of dress that it will be just below the knee. It does, will not go till the leg area, only on knee. So this group of people began to wear a dress that will till reaches to our hip, ankle. So that is what is. So there is a political discussions were made, they discussed and they found how now the French people or the executive decided to execute the king. Execution of the king, you can see here. His head is shown. Why did the people execute the king? They were so much unhappy and angry because he tried to conduct the charge of treason was put on him and he was executed. See, King Anne had was raised, King was executed on the other prison. On 21st January, he was executed. His head was cut and his wife also was taken and head was taken. And so many executions happened. So that a period of administrations and problems start from that. Then we can see some of the weapons of the time. See, this is a reign of terror, we call it. Threatening period. Everybody was being threatened. That is the period we see. People were so much frightened. This is a mission and a religion. This is a break. The body head will be inside. Body will be outside. The head will come. Cut. Body will be inside. That's the mission. This is a picture. So, this is a time when Robespierre has taken power. All those persons who spoke against the Republic or spoke against the Robespierre and team, all of them were caught, brought, and formally tried. Means, okay, you are done, okay. Other one person, there he has made a mistake, he has spoken against the Republic. Take him to guillotine, cut. So that is what has happened during the reign. Now, a new change has to take. So that is how that change will come.